question and this question have been asked by a lot of colleagues over email as well, and sometimes even on LinkedIn. And the question is asking, what's the difference between user throughput and cell throughput, and why the last TTI is excluded when we are computing user throughput sometimes? So great question. The question in itself, if you are hearing this, is simple enough. What's the difference between user throughput and cell throughput? User throughput, when you are measuring the throughput of a single user, is user throughput, and cell throughput is sum of all the users in a cell, should be equivalent to cell throughput. That's one way to say it. It's very simple. However, if there is just one user in the network and you are measuring throughput of that user and there are excellent RF conditions, and the user can have as much throughput as it wants, meaning the device has enough capability and excellent RF conditions are there, then the overall throughput which the cell can give to that user will be equivalent to cell throughput as well. But when you start dividing that particular user into a number of users and different users are in different RF conditions, then in that case, that particular throughput each user will have will be different. But the overall sum of those users, or sum of the throughput of all those users, should be equal to the cell throughput, and the upper bound we can consider it as the excellent RF condition throughput. Simple enough in that case, from the idea or from the concept. In other words, your cell throughput is the maximum bound and your user throughput will be divided into that. If there are just two users, your cell throughput in ideal conditions should be divided into those two users. Having said that, there can be different limitations when we do calculation or when we do computation when it comes to measuring cell throughput and user throughput. And what are these and what challenges do we need to find out? Usually a lot of people go into this dilemma or challenge of understanding cell throughput and user throughput because when they are computing KPIs or throughput KPIs for a different vendor equipment, the vendor, depending on their counters which they are using and whatever equipment they have, those counters are giving some different values. And one question which usually comes up is, sometimes in some cases, some colleagues, they face that user throughput is coming out to be greater than cell throughput. And how is that possible? Without going specific in a specific vendor discussion, when such a situation happens, the first thing to troubleshoot or take a look into is, you need to take a look at the counters which you are using or considering in the formulae for computing user throughput and cell throughput as well. Each of the counter which is being used, what's the definition of that counter and how that counter is being computed or when that counter is being pegged? That is very important to understand, because if you do not understand how that counter is being pegged at what particular condition, that may give you a wrong estimation or wrong answer, and it will increase the confusion as well. So that's number one to check into. Number two is to take a look into the application level throughput as well, because that's the end user experience or end user throughput. A lot of people, when they are trying to understand the raw throughput, performance engineers, their concern is, how can we understand what is the actual throughput the user is experiencing? So what the user is experiencing is on this device, which is the application level throughput. So if you have that particular ability to see what user is experiencing, that will be your application level throughput, which you can measure through third party apps as well. From a raw perspective, that's one way to compute the KPI based on counters and understanding the behavior of those counters. Another part of a similar question which comes up is, usually some vendors, when it comes to UE throughput computation, they allow the last TTI to be excluded from throughput computation, the throughput which is coming in the last TTI. And why is that? What's the reason behind it? The assumption behind it subtracting the last TTI and the throughput associated with that packet is, because usually when the buffer is emptied in the last TTI, so sometimes the coding rate is increased just because of the size of the packet. To make that particular packet to be bigger, the coding rate is increased. It does not really reflect the radio conditions, because if radio conditions are bad, in that case as well, coding rate is increased. So the reason or the assumption behind subtracting the last TTI throughput or packet is that by removing that particular last TTI packet out of throughput computation, that will not impact the end user because anyways the coding rate is not reflecting the actual radio condition. It may reflect just the size of the last packet, which will be emptied in the buffer as well. So some vendors do use that particular subtraction in the formula of their UE throughput as well. So keeping this thing in mind, you can always have an understanding about difference between UE throughput and cell throughput as well. And again, one last thing is take a look at those counters which you are using and how those counters are being computed and when they get triggered and pegged as well, whatever is the case. Thank you for the question.